Thank you, sir. I am thankful to you, Sabhapati ji, and to my leader, Srimati Mamata Banerjee, to allow me to say a few words on Railway Budget 2015 that is unique in propagating discomforts to the people of West Bengal. First of all, I thank you, Prabhuji, to make it clear that West Bengal is not in priority area of the NDA government. Though your government is focusing on improvement of eastern part of our country, as evidenced many a times in the House and outside the House, by presenting this holy budget, at least you proved it either your leader is committing some mistakes or you. It's my privilege to hope that you may be wrong. Why I'm saying this? Because there is no specific budget allocation for railway projects in West Bengal. Projects of 100 crores are stuck in West Bengal. Allocation is very limited. Sometimes back, Ramesh Bidori from that side made a very adverse comment on Srimati Mamata Banerjee, who announced some viable projects in her tenure. It was not completed, it was not continued due to the budgetary provision which is laid by the government subsequently. That Srimati Mamata Banerjee is the most popular railway minister in the independent India. Then there is no mention of metro railway projects in the annexure of the Railway Budget 2015. Please take this proposal from the eastern part of the country for execution and your kind consideration. My problem is my people, my constituency people and the people of West Bengal. We have lots of complaints, we have lots of grievances. I hope that this may be your problem also, because you are also elected members. Please look into the matter, as the Prime Minister of our country is supposed to look at the East. Last year, when the Finance Minister presented his budget, general budget, declared to set up an AIIMS in Kollayani, in Nodia district of our state. This Kollayani is an upcoming smart city. May you shed your kripa on Kolkata to Kollayani metro via Barakpur proposed route. When our leaders, where the railway ministers, they sanctioned some amount for surveying the possibility of those proposed lines. I think this will be a vital proposal for implementation. The numbers of local EMU trains running in Sialda and Howrah section are not sufficient. The frequency of the local trains needs to be increased, at least during the peak office hours. Millions of passengers are traveling in these sections each and every day. The number of compartments of the local trains needs to be increased from even 9 to 12 for accommodating the ever-increasing number of the passengers. The railway system, the suburban railway stations of almost all states, including West Bengal, are being neglected for so many years. I want to draw your kind attention to clean the suburban railway stations, the toilets, the bathrooms, that is right now in very bad condition. You should look into the matter. In my constituency, Ranaghat, the historical city, this city is divided by a railway station and the railway lines. there should be an underpass need to be made.
Please conclude.
For this area, the initial work has already been done. The remaining part must be completed to smoothen the process of people's movement from one part to other part. There are a lot of unmanned level crossings falls under my constituency. One of the unmanned level crossing is in between Ranaghat station and Cooper's Camp Halt. Highly populated area that should be looked into. Another important point I want to mention here, a lot of poor people living alongside the railway station, railway lines and stations. They are from very poor background and they are coming from Bangladesh as refugees.
Please conclude.
Please look into the matter for their rehabilitation in the better areas. I conclude my talk with the expectation that all of the proposals needs to be completed.